Hi, in this video walkthrough, you will be creating a web application that will be able to call you on your phone using the Vonage Client SDK. You can find a full write-up of this tutorial in the Vonage API developer's documentation. A direct link will be in the description. There are a few prerequisites that will be needed before we can get started. Let's go through this one by one. To be able to use the Vonage Client SDK and CLI tool, an account will be needed. Here's how to get one. Go to dashboard.nexmo.com, click Sign Up, fill out the form to create an account, verify your email address, verify your phone number, answer just a few more questions to help you get started, then you will be taken to the account dashboard. Take note of the account's API key and secret. They will be needed later. To be able to carry out tasks such as creating applications, purchasing Vonage numbers, and so on from the terminal, you will be using the Vonage command line interface or CLI tool. As the CLI tool requires Node, you will need to install that first. Go to the Node's download section of their website. Which package you download will depend on the operating system you are using. Once Node is installed, make sure the version is at least 6.0.0, which is required by the CLI tool. You can check this by opening your terminal and running Node space hyphen V. Next, you'll install the Vonage CLI tool. As mentioned before, this will make it possible to do many things from the terminal, like create applications, purchase phone numbers, etc. In your terminal, type the following command. Press Enter. Next, you will link the CLI tool to the account created earlier. In your terminal, type this command, making sure to replace API underscore key and API underscore secret with the values in your dashboard noted earlier. Press Enter. Next, the Vonage JavaScript Client SDK will be installed. This will allow the web application to communicate with Vonage to make the phone call. Create a new directory for the project. You can call it app-2-phone-tutorial and go into the directory. Now, to create a blank project, type npm space init space hyphen y. Then install the client SDK by typing this command. Press Enter. Now, the client SDK is installed into the node underscore modules directory within your project directory. A portion of the tutorial will require a GitHub account. If you don't already have one, you can go to github.com and sign up for one. If you already have an account, make sure that you are signed in. Next, the Nexmo call control object will be created. The call control object provides instructions on how to handle the incoming call request from the web application. In this case, the call control object will connect to the phone number provided. The call control object must be public and accessible by the internet, So GitHub gist will be used to accomplish this. In a browser, go to gist.github.com. Enter ncco.json into file name including extension. Next, copy and paste the JSON object into the gist. Replace phone underscore number with the number used to create your account. Make sure to specify your country code when entering your number. For example, in the US, add 1 before the number, and in the UK, add 44 before the number, and don't include any symbols. Click the Create Secret Gist button. Click the Raw button. Take note of the URL shown in your browser. You will be using it in the next step. Now, create a Vonage application in the project folder by copying and pasting this command from the tutorial into the terminal. Make sure to replace gist-url in the command with the gist URL from the previous step. Press enter. Two files are created in the directory. Also, the application ID is created. Take note of it. It will be needed in the future. There needs to be an authenticated user to be able to make a call using the web application. Run the following command to create a user. The name will be Alice, since that is a standard convention. This will return a user ID. The client SDK uses JSON Web Tokens, or JWTs, for authentication. The JWT identifies the username, the associated application ID, and the permissions granted to the user. It is signed using your private key to prove that it is a valid token. Use the CLI tool to generate a JWT for the user Alice by copying and pasting the following command from the written tutorial. Make sure to replace the app underscore ID with the application ID generated earlier. The generated JWT will be valid for the next 6 hours. Now for the web application that will be used to make the call to the phone number. Create an index.html file in the project directory. Copy and paste the application code from the tutorial into the index.html file. Make sure to replace paste your JWT here with the JWT created for the user Alice earlier. A few things to note in the code. Here is where the client SDK is being loaded from the node underscore modules folder. The UI that allows you to enter a phone number and then click the call button to make the voice call. Creating references to the UI elements. Logging in the user using the JWT and then returning an app instance. When the call button is clicked, the app.callServer function is used to make a call to the phone number entered. Note, since the phone number was hard-coded into the call control object, that will be the only number called. For a production application, the call control object is generated on the server. Some event listeners to handle when the hang up button is clicked and when the status of the call changes. To run the application, open the index.html file in an internet browser. Type in the phone number used in the call control object, including the country code, and removing any other symbols. Press the call button. If everything worked correctly, the phone should start ringing. You can answer it and hear yourself coming through the browser. Click the hang up button to end the call. To get more information on the topics covered in this walkthrough, please visit the written tutorial in the developer documentation. While you are there, take a look at the wide range of other offerings from Vonage and see what else you can build.